Picture the eyes of the country watching your every move. Consider singing live to over 30 million people. Imagine being cut after getting this close. It's happening to someone tonight. This is American Idol. Welcome. Nice to see you all. I'm Ryan Seacrest. Inevitably, Wednesday night has rolled around once again, which means bad news for one of our finalists over there. Let's hear it for him, ladies and gentlemen. But it's not all bad news for you guys at home. We've got music from Barry Gibb coming up live. Pink is here. Plus, a preview of the new Fantastic Four movie and a shot at $100,000. All of this, and your judges have swapped seats tonight, so let's follow along. Randy Jackson.
I'm here, right here, yeah.
Simon Cowell.
Yeah. What are you doing?
I'm Ben Cola.
Paula Abdul. Oddly enough, he has much more to work with than you do there.
Whoa!
And I mean that nicely, as a compliment.
Whoa! Don't start again.
Why did you swap seats?
Don't start again. Apologize.
It's like no. Jessica Alba's so hot. She's so hot. She's so hot. But it's 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Is she here?
She is.
You might see Jessica a little bit later in the show. Hey, Randy. You know,
you're hot, Jessica. You're hot.
Randy, going back to previous seasons, this week has usually been a shocker. What do you anticipate tonight?
I don't know, man. It might be a shocker tonight, too, dude. It's like, I think people are still a little confused, but hopefully not.
Now, the judges don't know the results yet. Nobody here knows, but I think, Nigel, you and I, right? I may know a little something. Paula, do you think having two songs helped them last night?
For some, yes. It was a difficult night. But, you know, overall, those of you up there know which song worked and which song didn't.
And Simon, can I just say that you were on form. You were just brilliant last night. I really enjoyed watching you.
Brilliantly horrible.
Brilliantly awful.
It's not just about me. These two little people have a little role as well. Come on.
It's a team effort. Is that what you're saying?
Exactly.
Yes, well, thank you for being with us, though. We appreciate everything you do. Simon Cowell, ladies and gentlemen. Now, we promised you some great songs on the show last night. Barry delivered. But did our finalists? Let's take a look.
I like it.
There are four great artists left. Now the heat is on. Now they all have to step up to the plate and really deliver.
This week has been an amazing week for me because I get to meet Barry Gibb.
Should be dancing, yeah.
Blake's beatboxing really suits this song.
Yeah.
Your beatboxing, nobody can do what you do, and you did show why you're unique and why you're on that stage.
I'll give you unique, but I thought it was absolutely terrible, that performance. Luckily, you got a second song. I want to see better than that.
This is the danger zone. This is where I came in.
Blake, you are the contemporary rebel in this competition.
Lakeisha has chosen staying alive. It does present a challenge, but you know what? She'll rise to it.
Well, Lakeisha, no kiss tonight, baby.
Simon, not the type that calls back after a first date.
Gonna change now, and we'll see what happens on the next date.
Much better than the first joint that you did tonight. So good looking out. That was good.
I know a couple of hundred people have sung this song, but I haven't heard a greater version than Jordan's.
I'm living with you, baby. Tell me what to do.
You don't know.
You just know.
Jordan, so far you winning, baby, tonight. So far you in it.
Thank you. I just left it all out there and got great reviews, so I'm gonna go cry now. Thanks. It's a ride.
Your best performance, it was pitchy kind of all the way through. It's a tough song though, it's a really, really hard song to sing.
I thought it was old-fashioned and actually very pageanty.
When Melinda chose Love You Inside and Out, the choice was a little unusual for me, but she pulled it off.
What am I gonna do if we lose that fire?
Four people left, okay? I expect incredible tonight. Yeah. That was not incredible.
I hope I do better this next time around, because I'm gonna have to bring it.
And let me live again, again.
I think the second half of that song has put you into the semi-finals.
So mixed reviews from the judges, but what does America think? Once again, we're at the Farmer's Market in L.A. to get your take. How about the Bee Gees music and Barry Gibb? What do you think of that?
I think it's amazing.
Oh, Barry Gibb, what a sweetheart. Oh.
What's your favorite Bee Gees song?
Staying Alive.
Woo, 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 woo. Staying Alive, Staying Alive,
there
Staying Alive.
Go. Oh, it's on. Let me see the finger in the air.
Staying Alive.
How deep is your love?
It's very deep. It's very deep for American Idol. Love the show.
Who is your love deepest for?
Jordan is amazing.
Jordan is just so fresh and young, and, you know, she has a lot of good energy, so I love that also about her.
These are kids that have come from small towns, absolutely, and next thing you know, they're famous, absolutely, and they're household names, and now they've met Bono and Barry Gibb.
And Brian Seacrest. Oh, Brian,
no. No, yeah, Brian. No, 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 Brian Seacrest.
You've ended up with a good quartet, but I think Melinda is the pro. Go Doolittle.
You like Doolittle.
Best voice. Best performer. She's excellent.
Who do you think will win?
I just don't know who the people are.
Who screwed up last night?
Blake.
No. Mom is a little harsh. You kind of have a Blake look.
I do.
I mean, yeah, the hair.
Every week he brings something different and original.
Yeah.
He's so much fun to watch, and you never know what's coming next.
I think the woman is the best.
Paula.
She is.
Wait, we can do good Paula claps. Do you want to see our Paula
please.
Claps? Paula claps like this.
Give me a P. Yeah, and where are you looking?
The best is Lakeisha.
Really?
Absolutely. She's got the whole package. She's sweet. She has that voice.
I love Lakeisha. She's my favorite. She's...
A lot of people are worried, though, that she may be out.
I don't think she'll be out.
Oh, every time she sings, I got goosebumps. She's sexy.
Hey,
she's
let me
beautiful.
See those goosebumps. Who do you think will win?
The Lakers.
The Lakers might. They have a good shot at it.
You're so cute and nice. I don't care what Simon says about you.
Oh, you're very, very nice. I don't care either what he says.
You can tell we have an hour to fill tonight. That's what they thought in Hollywood this morning, but a lot of people around the country voted. Just over 45 million votes, to be precise. And those results are coming up. Plus, in just a few minutes, Pink right here on this stage. Hang on. We'll be right back.
Over the past five seasons, the American Idol's live tour has packed arenas across the nation. This year, it's set to be the biggest ever. Over 50 spectacular shows featuring this season's top 10.
When the world gets in my face, I say, have a nice day.
It's your chance to see your favorite idols up close and personal.
Oh, yeah.
Biggest hits, the biggest hair, the biggest stars of season 6 will take the stage.
Give me your heart, make it real, or else forget about it.
With a broken wing,
it shines down in a blaze of glory.
Make making sure you're part of the excitement when the Idols Live show hits your area. Tickets go on sale the weekend of May 19th. Don't miss a beat.
Ah, yes, Sanjaya live on tour. Lock up your daughters. Our next guest has filled her fair share of arenas, too, singing Who Knew? Ladies and gentlemen, Pink. When we come back, we're running the Idol Challenge, so make sure you got a cell phone or a computer close by. $100,000 could be yours, plus, oh, your results live. Don't go away. Some of your best work, guys. You can head to AmericanIdol.com to see all the Ford videos, the same place where you can enter the following competition for free. This lucky lady is Natalie Howe from Phoenix, Arizona, and she won $10,000. And you got some braids out of it, huh? Very nice to have you with us. Now, if you'd like to be in the running for a shot at $100,000, a VIP visit to the set of the Ford music video and tickets to the finale in 2 weeks, go ahead, knock yourselves out. Here's the question.
Which American Idol went to Africa to benefit the Idol Gives Back charity special? To enter the American Idol Challenge, text the letter A for Ruben Studdard, the letter B for Carrie Underwood, or the letter C for Bo Bice. Again, text either A, B, or C to 51555. Anyone who has a cell phone or computer can play, and you can enter up to 10 times. Only 99 cents per text message. Standard text messaging rates apply. And remember, you can enter for free at AmericanIdol.com.
It's a tough one, I know. So it's amazing how many great songs Barry Gibb has written. And you thought with some of the choices, they may have been a little off last night, considering all those songs, didn't you?
Yeah, definitely.
Well, here they are. Police, thanks, Randy. Well said. With a tribute to Barry Gibb, welcome Melinda, Blake, Jordan, and Lakeisha with some great songs.
To instead of me tonight.
The words of a broken heart is just emotion. It's taking me over. Tied up in sorrow, lost in my soul. And if you don't come back, come home to me, darling. Know that there'll be nobody left in this world to hold me tight. Nobody left.
Sisters, ladies and gentlemen. My night has been made watching Bill Maher lip sync Islands in the Stream. That was fun. Let's hear your final four. Here they are. Who will be the final three? We will find out live after the break, I promise. Welcome back to American Idol. The votes are in and someone is out. Your finalists, ladies and gentlemen, here on the couch, waiting to find out who goes where. Lakeisha talking to herself in that commercial break. What were you talking about?
I said, if I go home, hopefully I remember the words and I don't want
to
cry.
I thought you were talking to Melinda. I looked up and you were just talking to yourself in your own little world there.
I have to give myself these little talks.
I understand. Jordan, how did you feel about preparing for two songs last night?
You know, it was kind of just like, I better pick them fast because I only have a couple days to learn them. And I really like this song, so it was kind of easy for me to memorize it. But it was kind of just double the trouble. So yeah.
Double the trouble.
Right.
And Blake, Simon said after one of your songs, I mean, to be blunt, he said it was terrible. In that moment, what did you want to say back to him?
Simon. I right after a performance, I'm usually in the moment, and yep. I don't want to say anything, so I usually just nod my head and smile.
So after you stewed a little bit, what did you want to say?
Oh, thank you.
Lakeisha, you looked a little uneasy last night. Why were you so nervous?
I had a lot of things that happened earlier in the day, and I didn't have on what I was supposed to have on, then the key changed, and then I was thinking and overanalyzing everything, and I don't know, hoping that Simon would kiss me again.
Why not?
His girlfriend's in the audience tonight, so let's be careful. All right? Hey, Terry. Oh, Terry. You look beautiful. Congratulations on everything.
Yeah, Terry.
Melinda, they said that you're good, you're consistent, but they want you to stand out even more. What do you make of that?
Well, it was kind of a wake-up call for me because my goal coming into this was to be consistent in the midst of all the different genres and everything. But I realized last night that I have to bring more to it. So, I hope I get the chance to.
Well, the top three get to go home. You guys excited about that? Going home and seeing those people you love so much that have been voting for you. They were also lucky enough to get a little sneak peek of the Fantastic Four earlier this week. Check this out.
What is it?
We were hoping you could tell us.
It's here.
This should be great.
This past Saturday, the top four finalists got an exclusive sneak peek of the upcoming film, Fantastic Four, Rise of the Silver Surfer. There to introduce the clip to our very own Fantastic Four was none other than the film's director, Tim Story.
Thank you for coming out to take your first sneak peek at it. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Everywhere this thing goes, 8 days later, the planet dies.
All that you know is at an end.
The encounter with a surfer has affected your molecules. It could cause you to temporarily switch powers.
You like volunteer?
No,
hey!
Oh my God! Come on!
We're all gonna be in the next movie, and I'm gonna be Johnny Torch.
I'm gonna be sexy.
What was that?
You know, the lady that was, she was like, mm-hmm. Don't act like y'all don't know the lady that was
just
going like,
mm-hmm.
There you go.
We are the Fantastic Four.
And the stars are with us tonight. The Thing, the Human Torch, Mr. Fantastic, and of course, the Invisible Woman. This is like a fantasy. You have no idea. Jessica Alba, ladies and gentlemen, she is here.
Have a seat.
Well, congratulations, all of you, on the film. Jessica, when is it coming out?
June 15th. Everybody has to check it out. Fantastic Four, Rise of the Silver Surfer. It is bigger, better, faster, edgier. You guys have to go twice. You'll love it. We had a great time making it, and we're so happy to be on the show.
Well,
it's a great show.
Well, just with respect, I do have results to get to in a few minutes. But no, I like the blonde hair. Yeah.
You like blondes?
Yeah. Oh, sorry. Okay, so back to our own Fantastic Four. We thought we'd take the opportunity to learn a little bit more about them. As it turns out, this stage isn't the only thing your finalists share. Take a look.
I like this color, too. Yeah.
I live in Bothell, Washington.
I am from Flint, Michigan.
I am from Glendale, Arizona.
I live in Brentwood, Tennessee. It's right outside of Nashville, and it's Music City, USA.
I am an only child.
I don't have any siblings. I'm an only child.
You know, I make lots of noise. I mean, hence the beatboxing.
My mom was a single mom when I was growing up.
It was just me and my mom and my grandmother.
My family is, I guess, your average family. There's four of us. I've got a mom and a dad and a brother. As a little kid, I looked the same. Just a little smaller, tinier version of me.
I was the inventor of the Afro Puff, because I wanted two little Mickey Mouse puffs on either side of my head, and I was very serious about them.
You know, you go through the awkward phases and the awkward years. I smiled like this all the time, like.
I thought I was cute. I had a nappy fro when I was a baby, really little nappy fro. I talked a lot in school, and that would get me in trouble a lot. My mom used to come up there, and the teacher would say, oh, Keisha was talking to the, she'd be like, yeah, I know she was, I'm gonna take care of that. I bet you when she come up here tomorrow, she ain't gonna be running her mouth.
Actually, when I was in the first grade, I was so, like, I couldn't pay attention to anything that my teacher had to set me between two filing cabinets.
I got kicked out of my choir class a couple times for being too rowdy.
I was one to never ruffle feathers. When I would go visit my dad, he was the one that kind of opened my horizon up to new music.
My mom never really pushed me for singing. It was my grandmother who pushed me for singing. My mom was always like, you need to go to school and get an education.
My dad just has been supporting me from day one. So has my mom. My mom's just like, she's an old rock blues singer.
I didn't get my singing talent from anybody in my family. It's just a gift.
I know everybody has a story. Oh, God. Okay. Everybody has a story, right? But honest to God, nobody knows what I've been through. So, you know, to be here right now is just wonderful. And this is the biggest thing that has ever happened to me in my life.
I love to dream big. And the bigger I dream, the more I see that it can actually happen. So I'm like, oh, let's keep going.
I never thought in my wildest dreams I would ever be on American Idol, ever.
I wake up in the morning and I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm on the show. I'm really on the show. People are watching me sing, and I'm actually here and I'm doing it. And it's just so crazy, because it's just what I've always wanted to do. And now I'm here.
Okay. We have made you wait long enough. The results. They're making me do this, are after the break. Sorry, it's the network, not my fault. Be right back. Welcome back to American Idol Live. Okay, Final Four, let's line up for the results. Ready?
No.
Great.
No.
Nope.
No.
Well, we have to. It's the way the show works.
No.
I got it.
No. Not gonna do it.
All right, fine. All right. Dim the lights. Here we go.
Wow. Here we go, guys.
Lakeisha, let's start with you. Can we see Lakeisha, though?
Open it.
We'll try. Show your face. You started with Staying Alive. Randy thought it was weird. Paula thought you lacked energy. For Simon, it wasn't great. With your second song, Run to Me, the judges thought you had improved, but Simon said you were vulnerable. Melinda, you kicked off the show with Love You Inside Out. The judges thought it was solid. For your second song, you sang How Can You Mend a Broken Heart? Simon thought you redeemed yourself and secured your place in the semifinals. Blake, you opened with You Should Be Dancing. Randy and Paula thought it was corny, but different. Simon thought it was terrible. He then sang This Is Where I Came In. Randy thought the beatboxing wasn't necessary. Paula liked the originality. Simon thought it was tuneless. And Jordan, you opened with To Love Somebody. The judges thought it was the best performance so far. With your second song, Woman in Love, Randy, shocker, said it was pitchy. Surprising. Paula loved you. Simon thought it was pageanty. Jordan, after the nationwide vote, you are safe. You may have a seat. Congratulations. All right. Jordan Sparks, friends. The rest of the results coming up in just a moment. First, so Barry Gibbs said that you should all perform together as a group. And that's interesting because we're actually looking for a group, a band. Watch this.
Over the years on American Idol, we've jammed with some of the best bands in the world. They've shown us what it takes to bring a crowd to its feet. Now it's your turn, America. If you play an instrument, if your band is ready to break out, the producers of American Idol want to hear from you. They're looking for the best undiscovered group in America. Any sound, any style, any age, anything goes. We're accepting submissions right now. Send us your DVDs, your band videos. You can send them all to The Band Show Castings. 8391 Beverly Boulevard, PMB 464, Los Angeles, California, 90048. Check out AmericanIdol.com for complete submission information. We'll give you the stage. Do you have the chops?
More music now. Time to introduce the man who had such sound advice for our contestants. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome songwriter, producer, performer, and legend, Barry Gibb.
There's a light certain kind of light that never shine on me. I want my life to be live with you, live with you. There's a way everybody say to each and every little thing. But what good does it bring if I ain't got you? Ain't got you. Baby, you don't know what it's like. Baby, you don't know what it's like to love somebody. To love somebody the way I love you. Mm-hmm. In my brain, I see your face again. To be so blind, and I'm blind,
so blind,
so, so very blind,
so blind,
and I'm a man. Can't you see what I am? I live and I breathe for you. But what good does it do if I ain't got you? Hey, babe, you don't know what it's like. Babe, you don't know what it's like to love somebody, to love somebody the way I love you. What it's like, baby, you don't know what it's like to love somebody, to love somebody the way I love you.
Welcome back to the Results Show Live. We already have one person in the final three. We need two more, which means one of you is going home. It won't be you, Melinda. You are safe. You may have a seat. Congratulations, Melinda Doolittle. You can join Jordan. Now we have Lakeisha and Blake. Randy, I'm going to put you on the spot. How do you think this is going to go?
God, I don't know. It was a tough night for both of them last night. I don't know, man. I don't know, Rye. I don't know, dude.
You don't know, do you?
Mm-mm. I really don't know. I really don't know, though.
Simon, do you know?
I don't know, but I could make a guess.
Go for it.
Don't. Oh, please
no,
don't.
Please don't.
Please don't.
Just don't.
Please don't.
You can guess.
Don't.
I was going to.
Yeah.
I think Lakeisha's going to go home.
Hold up.
Boo.
One of them's got to. Boo. Only two people up
Hold
there.
On. What would you like to say to these two before the results?
That you're both tremendous talents and that I've enjoyed every single one of your performances. And I've also enjoyed the ones that weren't as great, because what it does is it shows me you get and rise above adversity and you come back, and you come back winners each time. It's hard what you do. It's exhausting.
You
deserve a big, big career ahead of you, and I can't wait to be there watching you on stage.
Dim the lights. Here we go. Good luck, guys. After the vote, over 45 million votes. Blake, you are safe. You can have a seat. That means we lose Lakeisha tonight, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.
Here she is, the one and only Lakeisha. Take a look at your journey, sweetheart. Watch this.
I don't want to be free. I'm staying. I'm staying. And you, and you, and you.
You want to know? Hey, look.
I think people have more confidence in Keisha than Keisha kind of has in herself, so I just love to do it. And if it makes other people happy, then I guess I've done my job.
I got a 3.5-year-old daughter waiting on me. She wants me to make it, and I want to make it for her.
I actually could kiss you after that.
I'm glad I did audition for American Idol, and I'm glad people believed in me enough to think that I could be here.
Lakeisha! You should be very proud of yourself.
I am.
You've done a tremendous job.
Thank you.
Thank you for everything, okay?
Thank you.
And thank you for that shot of Simon and lipstick. We'll always have that.
Thank you.
Your top three take the stage Tuesday, 8, 7 Central. Your local news after Lakeisha.
Well, you can tell by the way I use my womb, I'm a woman.